Your Devio CR1T package consists of two main parts, the CR1 unit and the DTM1. We'll go over all the connections on both of these and what you should and shouldn't connect to each one. We'll briefly go over each of the connection points and then go back over each one more carefully. Starting with the CR1 and its front panel, from left to right, the first three connections are all USB 3.0 ports. Next, we have the HDMI input. This connection is intended to pass video, most commonly from a computer. There are cases where you'll want to use this and cases where you will not want to use it. We'll discuss those shortly. Lastly, on the far right of the front panel are the LED status indicator lights. One for power, one for microphone connection status, and one for auto setup status. The rear panel includes the following from left to right. The jack for the supplied 24-volt DC power supply. The pinhole factory reset button. A network port for monitoring and management of Devio. A 20-watt powered audio output intended for connection to a passive loudspeaker. A telephone interface connection. An RCA line level output intended for connection to an amplifier or powered loudspeaker. The microphone jack for connection to your Devio microphone. Another pinhole button, this one for initiating the auto setup process. A pair of HDMI outputs for connection to external video displays. A fourth USB connection. Now we'll take a look at each of these in a little more detail. We'll start simple with the status indicators on the front panel. There are three LEDs which give us four basic pieces of information, indicating various states of the CR1 itself with regard to its power status, its connection to a computer, its connection to the microphone or microphones, and the status of the auto setup feature. There is a detailed table on support.biamp.com/devio delineating the possible LED combinations. The short of it all, though, is the following. When everything is set up, connected, and communicating, all LEDs will be green. Specifically, the power indicator LED will be green when the CR1 is receiving power. The microphone LED will be green when the computer and microphone are both communicating correctly through the CR1. We'll further discuss the microphone LED later in this orientation. The third LED reflects the state of the last auto setup that was performed and also hints at the connection status of the microphone. A green light here indicates the last auto setup was completed successfully and the microphone is connected to the CR1. Refer to the auto setup materials for everything you need to know about this process. Let's take a closer look at the rear of the CR1. Nestled between the power connection port and the network jack is the pinhole factory reset button. Holding this button in for just a moment will reboot Devio and recall the factory default settings. You will need to use one of Devio's network configuration interface tools in order to change most of these settings. For that reason, factory resetting your Devio is not recommended unless you are in a position to access Devio in this manner. You would go about configuring Devio with these tools through the network jack. More detail on utilizing the network configuration interfaces are available on support.biamp.com/devio. as well as devio-help.biamp.com. Be mindful, though, that accessing the internal menus are not necessary for Devio to function. A standalone Devio out of the box and with all default settings will work. Additionally, Devio does not need to be on a network to function. Participating in a web conference via Devio relies on your computer's network and not Devio's. There are two audio output options for Devio, and they provide a good amount of installation flexibility. Yours should only be installed with one or the other, not both at the same time. The yellow connector is a powered output intended to connect a passive speaker and will give you 20 watts at 8 ohms. Keep in mind, this is a single output with the audio signal summed to mono. Use this powered connection to keep external active equipment to a minimum. The RCA output jacks are intended to be connected to an amplifier or powered speaker, like a soundbar mounted below your video monitor. These two are also mono outputs and can be useful if you found that more than 20 watts is necessary for your application. In between those two connections is a feature allowing Devio to be interfaced with the telephone. If your desk phone has a headset jack and the ability to disable side tone, connecting it here gives you the option to bridge a phone call with a web conferencing call. You can be in an audio or video conference using your computer through Devio. With your phone wired up here, simply activate its headset function and place or receive a call. All participants will be conferenced together, and all acoustic echo cancellation handled through Devio. The microphone jack should be fairly self-explanatory and will be put in context when we take a look at the microphone a bit later. The main thing to remember here is that the connector type is the same as the network connection port, so be mindful not to confuse the two when installing the system. The auto setup feature of Devio can be activated with this pinhole button by depressing it for just a moment. Auto setup is discussed in its own tutorial, so we won't go over it here. Finally, on the rear of the CR1 are the HDMI outputs 1 and 2, and another USB-A type connector, this one a USB-2 connection. The signal from these HDMI outputs are contingent on what input connectors are being used, and so can't be discussed without also including the front panel USB and HDMI input connections. So let's include those here as well. Now, USB and HDMI are likely familiar to most of us, but we should not skip over these particular connections, as there are a few very important points about using each that we need to consider. Most simply, the USB-A type connections are intended for any peripherals that you may want to connect to your computer. Memory sticks, wireless mouse and keyboard, slide presentation remotes, web cameras, etc. Devio is a USB hub, and so whatever you connect to these ports will essentially be connected with your computer. This can come in handy if you're using a really slimline device with a single USB connection only. The leftmost USB jack on the front panel, a female B type, is a USB 3.0 port. A 6-foot USB 3.0 cable is included with a CR1T package. This single USB connection can provide the only physical link between your computer and the CR1, passing all video, audio, and other communication. You will need to enable Devio's USB video feature and install the DisplayLink driver to enable video over USB from displaylink.com/downloads. This configuration, allowing the computer desktop to be extended to one or two displays and with only a single USB cable, represents the easiest and most simple way to connect with Devio. More information on setting this up is available at support.biamp.com/devio. Some organizations will choose not to deploy video drivers to their end users' laptops. We support these scenarios as well by providing a direct HDMI video connection from your computer to a single display. Any audio between your computer and the CR1, though, should still go through the USB connection. So to have video and audio passing through Devio without utilizing the DisplayLink driver option, you will need to have two cables between your computer and the CR1. HDMI for video and USB for audio. Now that we know how to negotiate the video signal in and out of the CR1, let's take a look at the audio path. We all know that HDMI will carry audio as well as video. For Devio's echo cancellation to work correctly though, we should only ever utilize the front panel USB B-type connector for the audio signal coming out of our computer. In fact, the HDMI input audio will not pass through the CR1 and out the speaker outputs. Only USB audio does so and gets processed along the way so as to deliver all of the echo cancellation benefits that Devio promises. These connections will output sound that has gone through the echo cancellation process. And for installation purposes, it is one of these audio outputs only that should be wired up. To use Devio as intended, there is no need to rely on any audio that may come out via the HDMI outputs. The Devio Use Case Scenarios video tutorial covers the most common and useful ways to wire your computer to a monitor and speakers via Devio. Refer to that video to supplement what we're discussing here. More information about the CR1 and DTM1, including tips for installation, are available on support.biamp.com/Devio.